we are discussing about nutrition in plant today with a few answers. I am going to end this chapter, which will be repeated in the exams. So with that, we are going to close this topic. In that, the first question is, Pratima said that this question always repeats in the exam. So please check this one, Pratima. Said mushroom is also a plant. Is she right? How will you support her? So this is the answer is. So please check this answer. What is given here is, Pratima said that mushroom is also a plant. Is she right? How will you support her? For this, the answer is, she is right. Means, what is that she is right means? Mushroom is a plant. Mushroom is a saprophyte. Saprophytes means what? Scavengers, which depend on dead and decaying parts. We know that. So it does not have a chlorophyll and cannot synthesize the food. So it cannot prepare the food. It survives on dead and decaying organisms. Because of this, it is depending on something and it is surviving. So we are telling that mushroom is a plant and it is, what is that? It like remaining plants, it also survives. But what is the thing means? It cannot prepare its own food, right? Okay, its own food. So she is right, mushroom is a saprophyte. It does not have chlorophyll and cannot synthesize the food. It survives on dead and decaying organism. Shall we go for the next answer? We are talking about photosynthesis. Next question is, photosynthesis is the way plants make food in every release. By using different items. Write your feeling on this. For this, the answer is, plants synthesize glucose by photosynthesis. The process takes place in green leaves? The glucose is used coming to here, see once, photosynthesis is a way plants make food in every leaf by using different items. Write your feeling on this. Plants synthesize the glucose by photosynthesis. We know that. So the process takes place in green leaves. The glucose is used for the whole plant. Means for the stems, roots, leaves, everything. So it is useful for fruits and even vegetables also. The remaining glucose is converted to starch and stored in different parts of the plant, roots, stems and leaves. Plants also need other nutrients. What are the other nutrients? Potassium, phosphorus and nitrogen, which are absorbed from water and soil. Where this potassium, phosphorus and nitrogen are present? They are present in the soil itself. By taking all these things, we will get a good yield. If the plant is taking all these things properly, then only we will get good yield and we will get fruits and vegetables well. So, plants synthesize glucose by photosynthesis. The process takes place in green leaves. The glucose is used for the whole plant. The remaining glucose is converted to starch and stored in different parts of the plant roots, stems, leaves. Plants also need other nutrients which are absorbed from the water and the soil. Shall we go for the next answer? Do you agree with Von Helmont if nutrients absorbed by plant from soil are equal to the mass of the plant what will happen and the right hypothesis. Now for this answer, So coming to the point here, do you agree with the von Helmont? If nutrients absorbed by plant from soil are equal to the mass of the plant, what will happen? Think and write your hypothesis. So what is the point here means, what von Helmont is telling? Von Helmont is partly correct. Okay, means not 100% correct. Plants do not get all the nutrients from the soil alone. If that is the case, the number of trees on the earth could be counted on the fingers. Did you understand? All the same time, at the same time, plants do not get all the nutrients from the soil and water, but the main source of its nutrients is food synthesized by the plant itself. So, did you understand? He is not 100% correct, but 50-50 chances are there. Von Helmont is partly correct. Plants do not get all the nutrients from soil alone. If that is the case, the number of trees on the earth could be counted on finger. At the same time, plants do not get all the nutrients from the soil and water, but the main source of its nutrients is food synthesized by the plant itself. So with this, our nutrition in plants lesson was completed. Tomorrow I will start respiration in plants and animals. We are going to discuss respiration in organisms. We are going to discuss that one. So with this, our nutrition in plants lesson was completed. So whatever I gave, those questions will be repeated in the exams. You must learn. Okay. Thank you.